first, I will fix my hair. No, just kidding. Hi, my name is Karita Brookins. I'll be doing my pre-trip air brake inspection for Class A. I'm going to turn on my ignition to check my ABS light to make sure it comes on and off. In this case, it did not go off, which means it's not working properly. I will be checking my six items. I'm going to check my seatbelt. Make sure it's not cut, cracked, frayed, or, you know, torn. Make sure it latches and unlatches properly. And then I'm going to check my steering wheel at 2 inches of play while, 2 inches of play here, and then it's like not missing any components. It has all its parts, it's working properly. My gear shifter is in neutral, it has all its components and it's working properly. My brake knobs are pulled out and they have all their components, they're not cracked or broken. My clutch, no more than 2 inches of play while tapping on it, it's working properly. And then my air pressure is needs to be below 80 PSI. So at this time it's about 99. So I need to go ahead and fan that down a bit and get it pretty low. So now it's at 70 PSI. So I will go ahead and safe start my vehicle. Clutch down, neutral, start. Release my clutch slowly. At this time, I'm going to do my cutout. I will rev up my RPMs between 12 and 14 to get a max cutout of my air pressure. It should be between 120 and 140 PSI. I'm going to go ahead and check for any air leaks in my system and make sure I don't lose any more than 4 pounds of pressure, 4 PSI. I'm going to go ahead and push my brake down until my needle stabilizes and then I'll start my count. Okay, so it's stabilized at 90. My minute starts now. Okay, 30 seconds has went by. I don't hear any air leaks at this time. All right, So my needle did not go past 4 PSI. It's no less than 4 PSI. It went down to about 90. It went down to 90 PSI. So now my minute is over, and that's it. It did not lose more than 4 PSI, which makes it a great test. Now I will proceed to my low air warning test, which means I shall see or hear a buzzer, and it cannot go less than 55 PSI. I will go ahead and start fanning my brake now. Alrighty, my buzzer came on at 60 PSI. It came at 60 PSI, which makes it a good test because it's no less than 55 PSI. Now I'll proceed to my spring brake pop-out test. It should be between 45 and 20 PSI. So I will start fanning my brakes until these both pop out. Which makes it a bad test because it was below 20 PSI. So now I'm going to go ahead and safe start my engine. I'm going to put my gear in neutral. They're all popped out, ready to go. Clutch down, start engine. I'm going to go ahead and release my clutch slowly. I will proceed with a cutout between 12 to 14 RPMs. Make sure my pressure is between 120 and 140 PSI, no more than 140 PSI. So that starts now, raising my air pressure. My cut set out at 130 PSI, which is a great test, which is great because it's not less than 120 or more than 140 PSI. So now I'm going to go ahead and begin my brake test. I'm going to test my parking brake, my emergency brake, my trail brake, as well as my service brake. I'm going to start with putting my truck in the low gear. Okay. Make sure it's in. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and release my emergency brake to test the parking brake. I'm going to go ahead and I should feel a slight tug or pull. There we go. So it's working properly. It didn't move to the left or the right. I'm going to go ahead and test my emergency brake. So fun. So I'm going to go ahead and I should feel a slight tug or pull. There you go. That's good. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and test my trailer brake. Put my trailer brake down. Disengage that emergency brake. I'm going to go ahead and I should feel a slight trouble pull with this one as well. There we go. Now I'm going to go ahead and put my foot on that service brake. And wow, that was good. And then I'm going to test out my service brake. So I'm going to also make sure my wheel is not going to the left or the right. So by doing that, I'll go ahead and hover my hand over. I'm going to go no more than 5 feet. I'm going to go no more than 5 miles an hour. I'm going to watch for pedestrians or any other vehicles in the area in the way. So here we go. All right. Zero didn't go left or right. Truck came to a complete stop. That means it's working properly. So, that concludes my air brake inspection for my Class A creature. I'm going to go ahead and secure my truck. Pull out my brake knob. Release my clutch slowly. Did I pass, Mr. Examiner, or what? Yeah. I'm scared as fuck, though, for real.
I did good, though.
Okay, I did good. Anything I missed?
No.
Okay.
So the only thing you did miss at the end, when you're done with the brakes, so with the service brakes, you have to say that they're well adjusted and well aligned.
Okay, that's something.
That's the only thing.
Well adjusted and well aligned?
Yeah.
Well okay, adjusted. Cool.
When can you put your hands back on the wheel after you test the service brake?
Alright. Thank you so much.
Once you test the service brake?
Yeah, when you test the service brake, when can you touch the wheel again? Is it like after you test it?
Yeah, like after you test it and then you secure your truck, you're already good.
Okay.
Yeah. Is it in there? Who's going to back it up for us?
Ooh.
All right. This big old truck, boy. I don't even know why. Sometimes